Man of the match performance. You carried your team throughout the 90 plus minutes against Mexico. Goalless draw, first point on the board. Marvin Phillip, you're up this morning. Must have a smile on your face, but obviously this is where it starts now because we have two games to look after. But tell us about your reaction to this fantastic result to start our campaign.
You know, going into a tournament, you know, you definitely need results, you know, to go as far as possible. Getting at 1 point last night, we started off on a good note. We went out there with a game plan. We executed the game plan for 90 plus minutes. And, you know, can't express the gratitude I have for the team for expressing the way that they showed that grit and determination to grind out that result.
You in particular, you know, you've come through something where you were away from the team for medical reasons. You missed the two previous World Cup qualifiers. You hadn't been starting keeper for much of this year and in recent times. And boom, you came into the lineup and delivered when called upon by your troops. You know, mentally, how was that like for you heading into the game and then throughout the 90 minutes as well?
You know, mentally, you gotta be strong as a goalkeeper. You know, most times goalkeeper don't really get much chances. So when you do get a chance, you know, you must take that chance. So I must say, over that period, I was mentally strong and always ready for when I'm being called upon.
The game itself, though, there were a lot of emotions during the game, intense moments as well. The partisan Mexican crowd, and obviously we had some things that we had to fend off as well off the field of play. But how did you maintain that sort of mental strength or being such a mental rock throughout the encounter? Go through some of the moments that, you know, that keeps ringing in your head after the game.
You know, going into the game, it would have been very difficult physically and mentally. You know, we played in the US, but you see that last night was a crowd full of Mexicans. So we needed to be mentally strong, of course. You know, all the pressures and from the crowd or whatnot, we just blank them off because we know we had a job to do and we stick to that game plan.
A little bit unfortunate to the first half injury. You did your part, nothing was done intentionally, and obviously the player had to go off the field, Lozano. You know, you want to express some form of hope and well wishes to him?
I definitely wish him a speedy recovery. As you said, it was an unfortunate incident. It wasn't something done willingly, so I really do wish him a speedy recovery.
Next up, El Salvador. We get a good result there and we're on point and on the way to the second phase. How important is it now for us to carry this momentum into these last two games?
You know, first of all, you know, our Trinidadian mentality, you know, complacency stepping comes very easily. So we definitely need to be grounded, we definitely need to be humble. And no going forward, we just take the momentum, all the hard work we had in last night games, we definitely take care of that forward and everything will be okay.
Okay. Marvin, just tell us a bit about, you know, you coming into a national team, you started at the under 15 level. You played the under-17 tournament in 2001 and you've kept going ever since. What does it mean for you as a young boy and now a man to represent Trinidad and Tobago?
It's definitely an honor, it's definitely an honor and a pleasure. You know, football is all I know. You know, starting from young, you know, I'm still fit and body feels well, and it's basically family and loved ones pushing me on.
And the fact that you can give hope and drive to the young boy on the block or around the corner or somebody who's on the junction in Williamsville where you come from. Tell us about that impact and knowing that you can have such an impact. What does it mean to someone like yourself?
Definitely means a lot, you know, having that, being that impact in the community. You know, always willing to help little ones, you know. From being strayed and being led along the wrong way. You know, sports in the community is very important. You know, well, our community is more or less cricket than football, but, you know, I'm also good at cricket as well. So being a mentor to them in that aspect is always a pleasure. I'm Marvin Phillip. I come from the community of Williamsville, and I'm pleased to be representing Trinidad and Tobago.